man born on a Harley. There's an easy act to follow, if you catch my drift. To paraphrase the press, we learn by imitation. We earn by innovation. Improvement, innovation is all about extending our imagination. I'm going to wind up making an unorthodox pitch for a radical, sweeping new form of 3D graphics capable of depicting anything from dual revenue streams to state-of-the-art, rapid response mechanisms. Whoa, talk about a quick turnaround. You know, this could give whole new meaning to, which I'm sure some of you recognize as the international symbol for PowerPoint slides. Figuratively speaking. Oh, talk about going digital. And I think that anytime you're an innovator, you've got to have a willingness to be unconventional. Sometimes in life, you reap the fruits, and other times, you eat the pits. But if you're able to have the kind of flexible thinking that innovation requires, you recognize that simultaneously, pits are also seeds. People didn't think I was going to get this deep, did you? Right now, the literal-minded are thinking, hey, that's two. That's not juggling. But the conceptual thinkers, the true, forward visionaries can see the invisible third ball. To quote the writer Carl Mays, sometimes it's only when we can see the invisible that we can do the impossible. I will now swallow the boxes. I'm hoping you'll be willing to help me out here with a little finger popping rhythm to these NEQC 55th Conference Blues. Farewell to rigidly fixating on one singular approach to speaking, and say hello to the creativity of offerings that this conference has to encourage you to carve out the cutting edge expertise and extreme, exponentially energized elocutionary eloquence that magnetizes for our audiences. And helps them to make the kinds of magical connections that can free their imaginations, to tap into each one of our innate capacities, back to up right, up left. What could make me feel this way? Section number one.
Fire.
Section number two. Long-range planning with right-on-the-nose strategic positioning for multiple markets, referrals, and repeat business. All solidly based on caring customer service that goes the extra mile. Of course, to stay hot and to stay on top, requires persistent trolling for new business contacts, relentless follow-through, constant outreach, bold networking, creative cross-selling, mutually beneficial, one hand washes the other, win-win collaborative ventures, and let's not pass over the most driving need of all, knockout branding. It's not easy for any of us to keep our balance. I mean, especially in light of all of the political upheaval and corporate restructuring, trying to find some way to smoothly align our professional goals, financial planning, family priorities, and personal needs is quite a puzzle. And somehow, amidst all this focus on catapulting our career, we're supposed to still find room for family, friends, unusual vacations, outside interests. I mean, is there anybody in this room who doesn't feel as if they just got too many balls in the air? Stop me if I'm wrong. But with so many variables constantly vying for our attention, just trying to keep track of all the separate items that just seem to show up on our to-do list. Not to mention our didn't-do list. I pause purposely because I am keenly aware that this strange hybrid symbolic alphabet has a very different impact on males than it does on females. I mean, it's sort of like, on the one hand, while the men strain to make the left and right hemispheres of their brain simultaneously match the rapid-fire verbal and visual imagery, some of the guys are... Some of the guys are still working on it. Of course, on the other hand, the women have such fluid, lightning-fast cognitive integration skills, they're already making mental notes and picking up on peripheral observations and sharing little side comments like, check it out, his balls match his shirt. When we do drop the ball, it once again is an opportunity. It's a chance to find the flip side of failure. It's a chance to be resilient and resourceful and sometimes to just recognize that the moment has come to take a failed, obsolete prop and have the courage to replace it with a new cutting-edge model. That's right, those of you at the front table here. We're talking about a lean, mean, quality machine. Of course, any way you slice it, I don't know how to say this delicately, but due to circumcisions beyond my control, sometimes when we have to deal with these sharp cutbacks and have to balance project demands and somehow handle all of the tricky turnaround time,